I say, it's that North chap again.
What course of action do you suggest, Hastings?
Ask Mrs. Redfern to make a sketch of him.
An excellent idea, my friend. Then Colonel Weston can send the picture to Scotland Yard for identification. Excellent.
N20, E15, N19. Poirot, they could be a map. The number of paces north, east, then north again.
And their starting point?
Albert Bagby at the Monk's Hood Inn told you that Tom Carter would spend hours on the island's summit. It was his favorite spot on the island. And we found Gardner poking about up there as well. I'll bet he's come to the same conclusion I have. This is a map to Tom Cutter's treasure.
Monsieur Poirot, thank you again for the sketchpad.
It is my pleasure, madame.
I intend to make good use of it today.
What will you sketch today?
I'm meeting Linda at Sanctuary Cove at 10:30. While she swims, I will sketch her gillymores for her.
You are kind to take an interest in her.
She's having a rough time of it, I'm afraid.
I believe you are correct. A friend now will be of great help, I think. Madame, do you have the time to make this small sketch for Poirot?
Why? I'd be delighted to. It's the least I can do.
There is a man at the landing of the sea tractor. Do you think you could make the portrait of him?
I don't see why not. I have a little time before Linda will be ready.
And madame, if you could contrive to do so without his knowledge?
Oh! I must say, it's rather exciting having a detective on holiday.
Monsieur Poirot, any luck with finding my typewriter?
Oui, mademoiselle. This is it not?
Yes, indeed. Wherever did you find it?
I would rather not say at present.
You are being most mysterious.
It is my nature to be mysterious, I am afraid.
Well, I'm happy to have it back. Thank you. Please let me know if there is any way I can repay you.
I will. Where are you off to, may I ask?
The Ledgers, to read my book. It's a rather good thriller by Graham Greene. Do you know his work?
Bien. He is an excellent writer.
Then I've a tennis date with Ken, Mr. Marshall, Mrs. Redfern and Mr. Gardner at 12. I'll just put this typewriter in my room, then I'm off.
Enjoy your day, mademoiselle.
And you, Monsieur Poirot. And thanks again.
Monsieur Poirot.
Good morning, Madame Marshall. I regret I have not yet found the writer of those notes.
I wouldn't worry myself if I were you. In fact, I'd like you to forget about them.
You have learned the identity of the author?
Yes. And if there's any further bother, I will deal with it myself. Is that clear?
That could be dangerous. An argument will not assist us, Hastings. Better to comply. I will do as you ask. That is a scent most charming that you wear.
Thank you. You're very kind. It's an expensive indulgence, especially for the beach. But I like it so.
You are going for the swim?
No, no. I wanted to use a float.
Use this one with my compliments.
You won't be using it?
No. I am certain of that.
Do something for me, will you?
Anything. Hastings, do not become smitten with this woman. She is charming, yes, but it will cloud your ability to investigate.
Sorry, Poirot. She's just so damned attractive.
Don't tell anyone where I am. Everyone will follow me about so. I just want for once to be alone.
She wants to be alone? I don't believe that for a minute.
Very good, Hastings. You read her character well. I concur. She has the rendezvous, I think. But with whom?
Morning, Poirot. See my wife anywhere about?
Has Madame risen so early?
She's not in her room. Lovely day. Think I'll have a bathe right away. Got a lot of typing to do this morning.
Morning, Marshal.
You look for Madame Redfern?
Christine is off sketching somewhere.